மார்கழி மந்த் டே 4 திருப்பாவை பாசுரம் 4th 1 ஆடி மழை கண்ணா ஒன்று நீ கைகரவேல் ஆடியுள்புக்கு முகர்ந்து கொடார் தேரி ஊழி முதல்வன் உருவம் போல் மெய்கருத்து பாழியம் தோளுடை பற்பநாபன் கையில் ஆடி போல் மின்னி வளம்புரி போல் நின்றதென்று தாழாதே சார்கமுதைத்த சரமழை போல் வாழ உலகினில் பெய்திராய் நாங்களும் மார்கழி நீராட மகிழ்ந்தேலோ ரெம்பாவாய். ஸோ இன் திஸ் பாசுரம் ஸ்ரீ ஆண்டாள் ரெஃபர்ஸ் த டீட்டி ஆஃப் ரெயின் அண்ட் ஷீஸ் டெல்லிங் ஹிம் டு அப்சார்ப் ஆல் த வாட்டர் ஃப்ரம் த ஓஷன் அண்ட் டேக் இட் அப் ஸ்லோலி அண்ட் ஃபார்ம் திக் பிளாக் கலர் கிளவுட்ஸ் அண்ட் த கலர் ஷுட் பி the color of Lord Krishna, so that the clouds will be full of water and come down slowly and continuously the flow of water for the people, which will enable them to grow more agricultural products, so they will be flourishing. So how it should be continuously is compared with the Sarangam, that is when Lord Rama sends is bow, it will be continuously given. If he starts with one, it will be followed by more and many. So that is what she says, the rain should be continuous so that the agriculture product will be more, so everyone will be happy and everyone will be prosperous. So here in this she explains a science concept: evaporation of water, then condensation, then precipitation. So the science concept water cycle is explained here. So it shows that our Vedas are much beyond the science. The Vedas have got the concepts of science within it. Science was discovered later. So Vedas are much, much ahead of the science. So she is calling all the gopis to do the nonbu, worship the God for the good amount of rainfall and for the prosperity of the entire country. Today's temple is Yogarama temple at Nedunkunam. In this temple you find Rama without any sarangam, without any weapons. In the pasuram we say சாரங்கம் நிறைந்த, பட் ஹியர் இஸ் நாட் ஃபவுண்ட் வித் எனி வெப்பன். ஸோ திஸ் டெம்பிள் இஸ் ஸ்பெஷல், இட்ஸ் யூனிக். திஸ் டெம்பிள், திஸ் பிளேஸ் இஸ் லொக்கேட்டட் 108 kilometers அவே ஃப்ரம் சென்னை, தட் இஸ் ஃப்ரம் சென்னை டு மந்தவாசி. தட்ஸ் அ பிளேஸ் கால் மந்தவாசி, விச் இஸ் 108 kilometers ஃப்ரம் சென்னை, அண்ட் ஃப்ரம் மந்தவாசி should proceed to Nedungunam, which is nearly 27 kilometers. And you can reach from Thiruvannamalai, 50 kilometers from Thiruvannamalai, and 24 kilometers from Arani. And this temple is very unique, and this temple has got various features. It's a very big and old temple, Yogarama temple. So the Raja Gopuram has got, that is the entrance, you find the Gopuram. It has got 5 tier. And immediately inside you can find another Gopuram, which is called Kili Gopuram. And here you find the main deity Sri Rama in sitting posture with eyes closed without any weapons. And why this Gopuram is called Kili? Let's see the Stala Purana of this temple. Stala Purana of this temple is Sukha Brahma Rishi was meditating in this place to have darshan of Sri Rama. Rama accepted his penance he was impressed by his devotion and penance, so he wanted to make Sukaprama's wish come true. So he, on his way back from Sri Lanka after killing Ravana, he was moving to Ayodhya. So on the way, he dropped here and he gave darshan to Sukabrahma Rishi. And Sukabrahma Rishi requested Sri Rama to stay here with him for a day. Though Rama was in a hurry, he had to visit Ayodhya to have Pattabhishekam, and he promised Bharata that he would come before certain day. He didn't have time to spare, but still he agreed to stay here because of his saulabhyam and sausilyam. He was so kind to bhaktas. So he agreed. So here you find Sri Rama in a sitting posture with his eyes closed, without having any weapons. He is not found with his kodandam. Only Lakshmana has his kodandam. So Lakshmana, Sita and Rama are here. And Rama keeps his hand placed on his heart in Chin Mudra. And he listens to Hanuman, who is sitting just in front of him. Hanuman is reading out the scripture, Brahma Sutra, to Rama. So inside the Garbhagraha, we see Sri Rama in this posture, Yoga Ramar. Keeps his eyes closed with Chin Mudra, in sitting posture, listening to Hanuman's reading. So Hanuman is in front of him. When we go around the sannadhi, you can see to certain extent the idol of Hanuman. Otherwise, you cannot see him when you are in front of the sannadhi. So this is very unique. This is very rare posture of Rama. After having darshan of Sri Rama at Garbhagraha, we can have a pradakshinam around it, but the pradakshinam path is very narrow and at lower level. And we can have the outer pradakshinam too, which is very wide, and we can have use of pillared mandapam, inscriptions and hills around the temple. And there are so many sannadhis located on the path. The sannadhis are for Narasimhar, Chakrathalvar, Krishna, Kalyana Srinivasan, and there is a separate sannadhi for Senkamalavalli Thayar and Vaikanasa Charyar. Only in this temple we find sannadhi for Vaikanasa Charyar. Vaikanasa Charyar is associated with Vaikanasa Agamam. The second Gopuram is called Kili Gopuram, which is named after Sukabrahma Rishi. Sukabrahma Rishi has parrot face and human body. And when we go around the temple, you find a hill just behind the temple. And this temple is considered as Sukabrahma Rishi because it looks like having parrot face and human body. So they consider the hill itself is Sukabrahma Rishi. And there is an evidence of Sri Padam of Lord Rama along with Changu and Chakra on top of this hill. This hill is called Dirghachala Hill. So this is evidence for the visit of Lord Rama, and he gave darshan to Sukabrahma Rishi here. This temple was built by Pallavas, and later times it was expanded with pillared mandapams and halls and sculptures by Krishna Devaraya. The sculptures depict the scenes of Ramayana and Dasavatara. It's a feast for
eyes. So this temple, Yoga Rama Temple, is at Nedunkonam. It's a beautiful place which is surrounded by hills, and you find Kaliyar River flowing on the other side of the temple. So we feel the vibration here.